Hello everybody and welcome to a new gaming video. Yes, what you're looking at is the screensaver of my television telling me it has no signal. It wants me to check the connections if there's something wrong. But no, there's not something wrong. Because I want to show you something. And of course, you have read it in the title. I've got my Xbox Series X. And what happened now? Also happened after I installed everything and the Xbox had its update, because the update part, if you turn it on for the very first time after you unboxed it, it takes a while before you actually can do something, because it's going to download an update. You can use your phone app to do some settings and sign in into your profile. But if after that is done, the first thing that I did was shutting down the Xbox to a complete standout. And I know that it's completely shut down if my external drive's light is also off, because then it's completely out. And then I can do a fresh restart. And I wanted to see how much speed we get from the internal SSD with the operating system running on a faster system. And this is what I did. So let's start it up right now. So yeah, it takes a while for my TV to actually see, hey, I'm getting a signal, because it's also loading the pictures that you just saw. But as you can see, the Xbox is booting up. And usually I'm used to the screen turning green, so it loads the profile. But as you can see, I'm being signed in and is ready. It's that fast. So the very first thing that I thought, this can't be true. It must have been either in sleep mode or it wasn't completely shut off. But right now, I just booted it up after work, and the last time I played the thing was yesterday evening before I went to bed. So it has been shut down for quite some time. If it hasn't been completely shut off, then it will never shut off anymore. So let me show you the settings. Yeah, this is also available on the Xbox One X and the Xbox One. I just choose a light background because I thought the gray was a bit, I wanted to have a bit of a next gen feeling, and now it feels a bit different, even though I just set my system from a dark to light theme. So let's see. Oh no, I was in the wrong place. I need to go to settings. Energy and boot up. And as you can see, it's in energy saving. It's the Dutch version. So I'm at the settings and then energy saving. I can also use standby, but as you can see, it's booted up so fast. Why would you ever want to use the standby function? Well, there's only one thing that springs to mind, and that is if you stop a game, stop playing, and you want to continue gaming exactly where you left off when you turn it back on again. So the quick resume function would still be in use. And if you're using the energy saving, it will completely shut down, of course. And so you have to reboot the game as well. Well, but to be honest, that's not even a problem, because let me show you the game that takes the longest to load and has an Xbox Series X patch. And that's Forza Horizon. I'm pressing the A button now. So this takes some time, but this was already the case with the Xbox One X that I had before this. And now the actual loading. I can skip some of these parts, so I'm pressing the button as quickly as possible. And it's loading. It's still loading. But yeah, I'm joking about it, but it's really quick. And well, judging by the time, yes, it's ready. I'm at my home, wild castle. Let's back out of this. Welcome back. Yeah, let's just go to the game. And we can play. It didn't took that long. What also took quite some time if you want to drive a different car. So, let's do this. How was that working already? Oh, never mind. Cars, of course, and then my cars. Let's go to Ferrari. C, D, E. Ferrari. Right now I'm in the Testarossa and I wanna drive. Yeah, let's do the 488 GTB or the LaFerrari also sounds nice. Yeah, let's do this one. Get in car. Would you want to deliver? Yes, of course. Well, here we get the load screen, but well, that load screen was really short. That's what it's almost instantaneous. So, usually, if you want to swap a game, oh, it looks like it's also updating something, the dying light. Usually, you're turning down this game if you want to play something different. And then you load the other thing. As a matter of fact, this is still a habit that I have. And this is because if I finish a game, if I want to play something else, I don't return to this game. So I like the quick resume function, but I'm not one to switch games all the time. So yeah, if I'm done with it, I'll just press start and I say, well, shut it down and it's ready. And also, just for fun, you can see it already here. I've been playing some Hot Shot Racing yesterday evening. For fun, I put this one on the SSD as well. And speaking of SSDs, let me show you how I did some things. Storage devices. The internal is SSD. The second one, I've also bought the 1 TB extension card because I filled up my internal disk day one. So I was like, that's not so nice. So let's get me some more storage. And right now I moved some more to the SSD Series XB because I wanna have some breathing room for the operating system. So I will definitely not put the percentage on the top, not above 90. So yeah, if I can find a game that's like a few gigabytes, so it's a bit higher, that's not a problem. So let's go, let's have some fun with this one. And it's not about the gameplay, it's just showing you the quick resume. And I kind of forget, no, I didn't turn it on. Because I always try to relax before I go to bed, so I play some Bejeweled. But Bejeweled don't like the automatic high dynamic range, which my TV supports. And the high dynamic range, yeah, this I can skip this one, but I didn't skip because I'm chatting. But so, high dynamic range, let's see if I have set it off or not. Settings. And that was options for TV, video modi. Yeah, I thought so. Now it's on. And I have to also restart the game. Otherwise, it won't use the... Shut it down and start it up again. Everything is just so snappy. The user experience, as you can see, my TV says, hey, I receive a high dynamic range signal. I haven't pre-ordered my PlayStation 5 on time, so like a lot of weeks before Sony actually said, okay, you can pre-order. I've already placed a pre-order, but when today everyone picked up their PlayStation 5, there were still 41 waiting people before me. And in my town, the local game shop, they don't get 41 PlayStation 5s in one go. So I think it will be maybe early next year, maybe even halfway next year before I can get the system. Well, I got my Xbox Series X, so I've got my next generation experience already. Let's press start, sign into my profile, and let's do a quick single race. The coast is nice. Yeah, let's do this one. Okay, let's wait for the loading. And the first load is always the longest, but as you can see, well, it's not instantaneously, but yeah, it is really fast. But yeah, the SSD was not made for small games like this, because even from an external drive, it's really fast with the loading. I hope my camera picks up the nice colors. Oh, my bad. Let's slipstream and get past behind them again. I usually save up all the boosts before I'm using them. But after this game, after this match, I will boot up some other big games which had long loading times, especially signing them into online Grand Theft Auto 5. Man, that was a slow game. Even on the Xbox One X, it's slow with the loading times. Man, these AI drivers, they are aggressive as heck. Oh, I get the full bar, so let's just get past them. But it has no use, because right now they are slipstreaming me, and they will be, as you can see, there they are. So what I usually do is I'll just try to make it to the last lap. I try to stay as close to the first position as possible, and then if I'm going through the final checkpoint before the start finish, then I'm going through all the boosts that I saved up, these four boost bars, and then they don't have a chance of winning. Of course, this trick doesn't work in the higher difficulty settings. Then you also have to try and use the boost early, and then when you go through a corner using a boost, you save up for a new boost. Okay, I'm going through almost to the final checkpoint. I don't like you. Oh, I'm already there. I kind of forgot. Never mind. But that's not a problem. Let's quit, and then let's really quit, and let's get out of the game after it stops loading. There you go. Shut it down. I'm going to show you two more games, and both are Grand Theft Auto games, because I also want to show you the backwards compatibility. And this is also a 3D game. 2D games, like for instance that Bejeweled game, when you use Auto HDR on it, the red jewels and the orange jewels, the colors are so close to each other, so that doesn't work. So I need to shut it off to use for that game. And what I would have preferred, that if you're on this game, for instance, if I would have Bejeweled selected right now, if I want to press the start button, now you get some options. I think if there's a new update coming for the Xbox, one of these options should be, if you start up this game, turn off Auto HDR. So right now I'm going to have to do this manually, but actually at each of these icons, I should be able to say, well, you don't need auto HDR with this game. That would be even more convenient, but well, this game doesn't need to have it shut out or shut off, I mean, because this game looks brilliant with the auto HDR on. Well, to my taste. The only thing that I have to get used to is it also changes the color of your map on the left, where you also see how much energy you've got or how much of your body armor is still intact. So you, yeah, this is the part where you used to wait a lot and then it swaps pictures, but well, it doesn't have the chance to swap the pictures because you get to see what level you're loading, and there we are. That is quick. I'll step outside real quick to show you the outside. Also, going down the elevator is almost instantaneous. And also very nice, this game has an uncapped frame rate, meaning this game is now almost constantly 60 frames per second. Well, and I say almost, in Digital Foundry they say they couldn't get it lower than 60 frames per second. But I saw another video where they booted up this game on the Xbox Series X, on the Xbox Series S, and on the Xbox One X. And there you saw, especially with the Xbox One X, was really bad with the performance. It was, especially when you are playing it, going down only in these like movie shots where you get an animation where you don't have any influence on, then the frame rate was pretty high and sometimes even a quite stable 60 frames per second. But as soon as the Xbox One X had to calculate the whole world again, then it was going down like crazy. And moving the camera like this was like a slideshow, and right now it's smooth as butter. Oh man, this is a huge step up. And it also improves gameplay. These hiccups, these like not the frame rate, but the frame time. It's nice and even in this game now. So you don't feel these strange slowdown effects anymore. And definitely, because this save game is from when I was still playing with the Xbox One X, but I wanna start all over again and play the complete story on the Series X, but I'm not going to do that now. The video will take too long if I do this. So as you can see, the experience on this game, or on the Series X, is amazing. And it's like a quality of life feature, the speed, that if you've used this, you can't go back to the One X or the normal Xbox One. Man, these speeds are really amazing. And I'm also planning on restarting that cowboy game. I kind of forgot the name, also from Rockstar. Because now with these speeds, I thought the loading times were terrible on the One X. And I was like, I don't play this game. But I'm going to give the game another chance. But now, another game that's making great use of the auto HDR function. It looks really nice now. And I can't imagine, I hope that the new version will look even better than this, because I wonder why they make a new GTA, because the Xbox Series X already improve your older version, especially when it comes to the loading times. So let's see when they finally release it, how it works. What I'm going to do now is I'm loading into the story. Well, we're already there. I didn't expect it to be this fast. And now let's sign into online. Well, I don't want to join Open Room at the moment because this is only an example. So invite only session. Yes, let's stop. This usually would take a long time. And then when you go back to the story, if you've done something, and I want the game to save before I shut it off. and I want to make sure that the jobs that I did, that the money that I earned is being stored. Well, I saw the screen flashing, so I think it's ready to zoom into the world again. Yes, it's clearing up. And there we go. This is also so much faster. Usually it zooms into the ground floor, then you get to see the side of your arcade, and then you are into your arcade. But right now this is was like it's zooming in, and it, before it even could show the arcade, I was already in the game. So yes, the Series X is so fast. I also got this game on PC, and my PC is quite new. It has, let me see. Sorry for having to move because I don't memorize the video card out of my head. So I'll turn on the power. I can't see it right now. It's an RTX. I can't read it yet. Let's see. Yeah, RTX 2080 Ti. And yeah. So it's not a child's play thingy. It's supposed to be even better than, never mind. It's supposed to be even better than the Xbox Series X. But the boot up time of my PC is slower. And also with this game, the game starts up faster. I'm signing faster into and out of the PlayStation, never mind. Grand Theft Auto Online part. So yeah, I'm really happy with it. So, let's go back to the story. So you can see how fast that goes. Because of course the 3D engine is now already in its memory. So switching back to the story mode should be even faster than going from story mode to online. And yeah, I saw the screen flashing. So it's already finished loading. It's going down and there we go. Yes. Well, of course, with this, the story, it won't skip if it's finished loading because it's want to show you this animation. But when you are going back to online, there's no animation to play. So when it's zooming in into your position and it's done loading, you get an instant, well, there you go. So, yeah, you know now where I'm busy with. That I'm enjoying my new Xbox. And well, of course, I'm hoping for my PlayStation 5 to arrive soon as well. Because to be honest, my Xbox One X didn't need a replacement because it was still in pretty good condition. And the only thing that, I did that because I gave it away to my father. And so I made a reboot to factory settings, and yeah, that made it quite a bit faster. It was like as if it was new, because well, let me show you why. Let's exit this, shut down. What the Xbox don't like is me having so much games, and on boot up, like 459 games. Some of them are from Game Pass, but not all of them. Most of them are bought. And they are split into internal, external. Both are 1 gigabyte or a terabyte. And there we got a two terabyte external drive and a 10 terabyte external drive. And these drives are pretty slow, so it takes quite some time to even load the inventorization of these two drives. And that is slowing the Xbox down a bit. And so I'm planning on, in the future, replacing these two mechanical hard drives with external SSDs. So like the ones they showed on Digital Foundry. And that was also pretty fast, and you had some more speedy access for backwards compatible games. So, because right now, let's show you the contents. I got like I'm going the wrong way. Valhalla, Warzone, Crackdown, it's not even an X Series X or S improved game, but it's a game that I like to play once in a while, and the faster loading time makes the game even more enjoyable. Well, Dirt 5, Forza Horizon, Gears, of course, the GTAs. Gravel was a game that never ran well, not even on the Xbox One X. It had frame dips. On one stage, it even came down to a crawl. I don't know how many frames per second, but I think it's in the single digits. So bad on that particular part of on a certain track. I can't memorize it all. Well, I downloaded this. I haven't played it on the Series X. I kind of, when I said I want to play the cowboy game, well, this is part two of Red Dead Redemption. I want to start all over again to give the game a chance. Now it's loading much faster. And then we got Tetris on the internal. And that is everything we've got on internal. And on this one, we've got, let's go up first, Assassin's Creed Unity. I'm a bit disappointed in, the game had a patch because it ran really bad when it was first released, but it didn't have a frame rate cap. So now in the test of Digital Foundry, the game ran at 60 frames per second. But now with the update on it, it only runs 30 frames per second. And the problem being, I can't play it anymore from the CD. I don't know how they do it. But when I install my disc version, because I still got it on disc as well, and I want to boot it up, it just won't go. It says, I need an update. And if I refuse to download the update, the game just won't boot up. So I don't know how they did it. Maybe they don't have the Xbox One X or Series X, connected to the internet. But if it's connected to the internet, you can forget about it. Black Flag was also a test. But if I'm running into storage problem because I want to download a new game that needs the fast drive, then Black Flag is the first to go. Forza 7, also nice to test with the speedy downloads. Halo had some installation problems, language-wise. It had like Chinese or so, a title, so I couldn't do anything with it. But I'm not much into Halo, but I wanted to give it a chance to see what happened if you played it on this one. This one, of course, it's so small in size that this can go to the external storage, of course. Or is also enhanced. And the crew and the crew 2, they really took a long time to boot up. So I wanted to test them out on the faster SSD drive. Well, this was my introduction video of the Xbox Series X. I will be doing a full review on it if I have some more time with it, and to see if I run into problems. And yeah, but so far, so good. Still having a great time on it. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.